Hello, my dear students. Now we are going to discuss strategies for enhancement in food production. Before this class, we completed just introduction part one. Now, what are the crop improvement methods? Because of green revolution and the gene revolution, now our country in a position to export plant biomass to other countries, not only supplying required quantity of food to our nation. Along with that, now we are in a position to export plant produce to other countries also because of crop improvement methods only by producing hybrid varieties. Now, what are the crop improvement methods? Crop improvement methods or plant breeding methods. Both are same. Okay, so first one, introduction. Second one, selection. Third one, artificial hybridization. Fourth one, mutation breeding. Fifth one, polyploidy breeding method. Sixth one, genetic engineering. That is RDNA, recombinant DNA. R stands for recombinant DNA or chimeric DNA, recombinant DNA. Tissue culture. So 1, 2, 3 oldest methods, conventional breeding methods. With the advancement in genetics and molecular biology, that is molecular basis of inheritance, that is concerned study of DNA, what are the functions of DNA genetic material. So with the advancement of genetics, molecular biology, tissue culture, our scientists designed new crop improvement methods. Okay, so introduction is not given in our text, believe it, not required. Actually, what is introduction? For example, this is a new plant with desirable characteristics. Okay, so okay, this is having robust growth, luxuriant growth, more number of leaves, more number of flowers, more number of fruits, for example. Means this is a desirable plant, plant with desirable characteristics. Select it and introduce into the area where it is not naturally growing. That is introduction method. Suppose now you are visiting your neighbor house, or you went to some village where your grandparents are living. There you observed a new plant, which is not existing in the area where you have been living. So simply what you will do, select that plant and introduce into your native area or not. That is called as introduction. For all crop improvement methods, the common method is selection. Selection is common for all methods. Whatever the method, whatever the crop improvement method, we have to select a parent. We have to select a plant with agronomically desirable characteristics. So selection is common for introduction, hybridization, mutation breeding, polyploidy breeding, genetic engineering, tissue culture, or some other technique. We have to select a hybrid variety with a desirable characteristics. Okay, so selection is common for all. In selection, one is natural selection. Natural selection. Nature is able to select organisms which are able to survive in the climatic condition. If plant is able to modify its characteristics, if it is able to adapt new climatic conditions or changing climatic conditions, definitely the plant is able to survive in that habitat. That adaptability is also called as acclimatization. Acclimatization, adaptability. So nature is able to select organisms. And second one, we are selecting, that is artificial selection. Artificial selection means human beings selecting certain number of organisms which are able to serve our basic needs. For example, we selected a dog, artificial selection. Okay, we selected a cat, domesticated or not. That domestication process, what is a domestication? Process of bringing organisms under human management to serve our basic needs. So for that one, we have to select the organism. That selection is called as artificial selection. So we have to select an organism with agronomically desirable characteristics. Okay, next. This third one is well known to you. Within the chapter, sexual reproduction in flowering plants, artificial hybridization we studied. Okay, so this is according to textbook, artificial hybridization is a conventional, traditional, classical hybridization method we studied. And the mutation breeding, production of hybrid varieties with the help of mutations. What is mutation? Sudden heritable change, inherited, that will be transferred. Heritable change happening at the genotype of an organism. Next, polyploidy breeding, increasing the ploidy 2N into 4N, 5N into 10N, haploid into diploid. By increasing the ploidy, definitely we can produce a hybrid variety. Next one, genetic engineering, transfer of desirable genes, specific gene, only one particular gene that codes for disease resistance, pest resistance, drought resistance, saline resistance, okay, temperature resistance, like that. So many are there. So we have to transfer a particular gene. We can transfer a particular gene into hybrid variety with the help of genetic engineering. Tissue culture, production of hybrid varieties with the help of tissue culture. We will see one by one. Okay. So these are various crop improvement methods. In our textbook, they explained all the events which are present in artificial hybridation. And after completion of artificial hybridation, they explained, they mentioned about what about the achievements, what we achieved out of artificial hybridation, and after that mutation breeding and genetic engineering and tissue culture. We have to study achievements also. Achievements means what type of cultivars we produce. Cultivar means a hybrid variety or plant variety which we are cultivating is called as a cultivar. Variety which we are cultivating simply. Okay, is it clear? So that's about various crop improvement methods. Okay, now first we have to select the artificial hybridization. Okay, so what are the steps present in artificial hybridization? So before moving into various steps given in the second year textbook, inside textbook under the heading strategies for enhancement in food production, we should go back to sexual reproduction flowering plants, where we studied various steps present in artificial hybridization. Okay, so what are the steps present in artificial hybridization? Okay. Okay, so what are the steps present in artificial hybridization according to first year part? We should recap or revise at a number of areas present in artificial hybridization studied in our first year textbook. So what are the steps present in artificial hybridization? So first one is selection of, this is the first year part, what you studied, selection of parents means plants as parents, selection of parents with agronomically desirable traits, or you may use characters also. Okay. For example, A is the parent we selected. For example, parent one, A parent. A is the parent, parent one. Okay, next. B is the parent, B parent, dummy one, it's not real one. Okay, so we selected A parent, B parent with agronomically desirable characteristics. Okay, right? So both the parents are in heterozygous condition. A parent heterozygous. We should know what is heterozygous condition, heterozygous, and this one also heterozygous. Okay, so how to understand a heterozygous condition? What is heterozygous condition? Each and every organism is having a number of genes. Okay, in that organism, if certain number of genes, maybe one gene or two gene or certain number of genes. Okay, if that gene is with contrasting alleles, go back to 10th class. In 10th class, you studied that capital T, crossed with the small t. That is your 10th class knowledge. Pisum sativum, tall plant crossed with Pisum sativum, dwarf plant. So here, these two are alleles of a gene. These two are alleles of a gene. And these two are alleles of a gene. This is a parent one or plant one. Parent one. P is parent. Parent. Plant. Okay, so now both are in homozygous condition. Okay, so how to understand a homozygous condition? Already I told you at the time of meiosis. For example, this is a chromosome one. This is the chromosome two chromosomes. Here, meiosis knowledge is very, very important. At the time of meiosis, parental chromosomes means homologous chromosomes, mother, father chromosomes are paired. That pairing is called as synapsis and formation of bivalents. Okay, right? So, first plant, for example, here, capital T. Here, capital T. This is a locus of that gene. In this area, that gene is having same type of alleles. Okay? So, crossed with the second parent. Small t. Here, gene is with the same type of alleles. So, this one is a homozygous. This one is a homozygous or homozygosity. Homozygous parent. This one also homozygous parent. So how to understand a homozygous condition? Already I told you, what is homologous chromosome? Simply remember one thing. Our chappal size, for example, my chappals are shoe. 10 number, homologous. Your chappals, 7 number, or somebody, 8 number. Number I'm telling. Generally, when we visit a chappal shop, generally they will ask, what about the size of your chappals? 9, 10. Generally, we used to wear 10, 11, 9, 9, 8, 8 only. That is a homologous pair. Okay? Anybody wearing 7 number chappal, 10 number chappal? No. That is a heterologous. So these two are homologous chromosomes. Reason? The gene is represented by same type of alleles. What is allele? Allele is a form of gene. Allele is a form of gene. So according to our knowledge, this gene codes for increase in the length of the stem or plant. This gene is coding for dwarfism, tall plant. This one is a tall, this one is a dwarf. Okay. Recessive character, dominant character. Okay. Homozygous condition. Reason, this gene is with same type of alleles. If cross is come after completion of cross, according to your knowledge, what about F1? F1 is with a capital T, small t. Capital T, small t.